everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today I am starting my seeds. It's a little too cold outside to do it yet out there. Last night it was in the 20s. Today it was in the 30s, maybe pushing up toward 40s. Still too cold. I got a little bit of a late start, but it's not too late. And what we're going to be using this year is called a biodome. It has some very nice features to it. It's got this plastic dome that is very tall, so your plants can get a little bit taller than perhaps if you had it in a smaller area or just under plastic. It has these little vents that can open so that if you see that there's too much moisture, you can do that. It also is very easy to just lift off the dome. It's very light, so if I need to give one side more light than it seems to be getting, then I can switch around. It has a styrofoam bed that sits in a tub that will have water in it. And the water can be either a quarter of an inch or a half an inch. And that will put just enough water into the little sponges that you don't need to water it from the top. It'll bring just enough for the plants.
So it wicks up.
It wicks up through these little sponges. So when you're ready to plant, you take one of these little sponge inserts. It already has a little hole for the seed. If you're doing a really fine seed, like we're going to be doing some coleus, you just set it on top and it'll just wick right up to where it needs to be. So when you're ready,
and then those go in.
Those go in the hole.
Okay.
You push them down and then you put your seed in. So I think I'll start with a bigger seed and just get a feel for it. What I've done is I've gone through each one and made a marker for what each one is, because I'll never remember. I mean, if I had three things in here, I might not remember. And in order to do that, we unfortunately had to replace one of our vinyl shades. Venetian shades, whatever. And these, we were told by a very experienced gardener, these are the best markers for your yard. If you're just planting things and you just want to know what they are, you cut them to whatever length you want. I'm writing on them with a construction marker.
Are they hard to cut?
Not at all. You can just cut them with a little scissors. It's easy to do. Decide how long you want them. Cut them. Decide how wide you want them. Maybe you want it the full thing. But because I'm putting them in here, I wanted them to be able to easily go in. So I cut them in thirds. And then I marked them.
And then, of course, you have a nice batch in reserve in case you need more.
Well, you get a whole lot of them when you take down a shade. There's a lot of little blinds there to use. So it was nice for us in one way, and we had to spend some money for a new one, but we need it. Let me start with one that's a little larger.
Now, do you have to put all the plugs in first? I mean, before you start seeding, or at
well,
least a group
actually,
of plugs?
They were saying to put the seed in first, but I don't know.
If you're pressing them down.
If you're pressing them down, right. I don't think you would have to.
I would think you'd want the plugs all in place before you even get started.
Well, if I knew how many exactly I was planting, that would be good too.
Well, you decide. I'm planting five, I'm planting six, I'm planting seven.
Plant five cannas over here, because that's all the seeds I have. So if I'm going to use them all up, five is what I'm going to use.
So there's only five seeds in an entire package?
Yes. They're very special. My husband got them for me.
What a guy.
I know. And then at the very end here, I'm going to put my little marker. Of course, if I come up with some other thing I want to plant, I might have to take that out eventually. Okay. Come on. Well, that's what they look like.
BBs. No offense, BB. I'm not referring to you, BB. Please don't take offense to what I'm saying, okay? Behave yourself over there.
Actually, they remind me of tree peony seeds. Yeah. Or perhaps rabbit pellets. We won't go there.
No.
So I'm just going to stick that down in the hole and just push it down that much.
Kind of like Alice in the rabbit hole?
Come on, get in there.
It's amazing how sturdy those sponges are. I would have thought,
yes,
you know, they'd be made out of material that would literally fall apart if you pressed on them.
Nope. And then when I get ready to plant these outside or in a bigger pot, you just take the whole thing out and you don't disturb your roots, which is wonderful.
Yeah.
Just wonderful. The next ones I'm going to plant are an annual that we bought last year. It's called a popcorn plant, family Cassia. It is in the legume family, and the neat thing about this is it has beautiful leaves that are just very lovely, but it has flowers, very pretty yellow flowers. When they're pretty mature, you take some of the leaves and you rub them between your hands, and it smells just like freshly buttered popcorn.
I could go for some popcorn right now.
Fact, I'm busy right now.
Could you put that in the popper?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
The seeds are fairly large, which makes it easy to plant.
If you can get them out. Yeah.
Come on. I even cut that one so I can get it out easily. There's one.
Yeah. They're fairly large.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, some of those seeds that you have are so tiny, I barely can see them.
Yes, that's why you don't put those in. It says to plant really tiny ones on top.
Well, what happens if you move the whole tray? Won't they fall off?
No, because the sponge is kind of rough on the top.
Okay.
All right, so let me get my sponges in here.
Now, what if you were to alternate the rows so that you leave an empty one at that side? Put one here. There you go.
You're trying to get me all mixed up.
Well, no, it's just alternating so that you can see, oh, golly, there must be a new group of seeds there.
Put that in there before I forget it. All right, and then I'm just going to put it down in the hole there. Get in there. And I'm guessing when these are down far enough, they will not be bothered by the brightness because they're in a dark. I'll put both of these in this one. Oopsie. Come here.
Good thing you don't have water in there, okay?
They're slippery, too. Must be all that butter. Okay, there we go.
I must admit, that popcorn plant really was unique.
Yes, it was.
I'm glad we experimented with that last year. So what's next on the agenda?
These are the rare vanilla strawberry hydrangeas. And they are also large. I'm hoping I can even get them in those holes.
Well, why don't you get your plugs in first?
Okay, let me get that.
A lot easier.
There.
In fact, I'm going to put the camera down and help you.
Thank you. I have one whole side done. Okay, so I started with the orange canna, the popcorn, the vanilla strawberry hydrangea, the eggplant, the little fingerling eggplants, marigold superhero spry, hello yellow butterfly weed, and blue primrose evening blooming, The mystery one that we have no idea, those little guys got everywhere. They were real tiny, so you can see that they're just sitting on top of the sponge. And I know some of them bounced over. So we may have some of those coming up, whatever they are. These are those fantastic old Getty squash, the big pink banana squash looking.
The 800-year-old seeds?
Mm-hmm. And then Tim gets his whole back row with his monster sunflowers that he sent
us. How does he rate getting a whole row?
He gets a whole row.
Well,
plus,
boy.
I saved enough. I still have plenty. I'm going to put some more outside.
Oh, okay.
We are just going to be all over the place. As seeds are packed, they are packed in different ways. Now, this is a pelleted seed. That means it's bound up with another seed. This is a petunia, one of the wave petunias. It's pink, and then there is a blue dawn that goes with it. And this is how they came.
So they're like little, in a vial.
They're a little vial, right. So you can see they're kind of enclosed so they don't fall apart.
So they put a coating over the seed.
Yes.
That's why they call it pelleted.
It's kind of like a little, you know, glue or whatever they're using. But you can see that there's the seeds are there. And this is, I guess, the new thing. Put two different kind of flowers together and let them grow and intermingle amongst themselves.
Hmm.
So that will be in this first row here. And I have six of them, so I'm going to put two in one. Who's the lucky one that gets another put on the end? Okay.
Now, no, that wasn't the only pellet or the only seed that came in a vial.
No, here's another one. This is the Coleus Kong Empire. This is a mixed pelleted seed. So let's see what this one looks like. I can feel it. It's like in a little vitamin capsule. And there are the tiny little seeds. For being a Kong, they're awfully tiny.
Hmm.
All right, so this one, we get the capsule apart. There they are. Now these I am just setting on top of the sponge, if I can pick them up. So I'm just
Maybe you need a tweezer.
Almost. But I don't want to squeeze them too hard either. Oops, one fell in. Get over there. Oops, he fell down beside. He jumped over. They are antsy.
Those are tiny.
Oh, you haven't seen anything yet.
Great.
All right.
Did you want me to get the tweezer?
I don't know if that'll help or not. Maybe I'll just tap these in. This is Coleus Giant Palisandra.
But look at those seeds.
Mm-hmm. Look at them.
You barely see them.
Yep. So I think I'm just going to tear this.
You know, something we have never witnessed is a coleus going to seed. Now, I don't know if our growing season isn't long enough or we just have been missing them.
Or I just cut the flowers off because I don't want them to go to flower and get scraggly. That could be.
I think you need to let them go to flower or go to seed, I should say.
All right. Now, this is going to be, I don't think that's going to work.
Nope.
Here they are. How they even got them in that envelope is beyond me.
And then having to sit there and count them.
Yes.
So that you know you have five seeds or 10 or 15.
Did I put the marker in? I hope so. Yep.
That's another thing, too. Label, 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 and more label. Because if you don't, you're going to forget what you planted because this tray is going to move around.
Right.
So you've got to have a system.
No, they're going somewhere. I can only hope that they are in the sponge. We'll see.
Well, that's one of the fun parts of being a gardener is you learn from experience. So you try things, and if they work, great. If they don't, you figure out, what do I need to do differently?
Right. All right.
Kind of like raising a husband. I hear you chuckling.
Colia seeds are smaller than poppy seeds. And poppy seeds are pretty small. There we go. This one supposedly had 20 in it. Mm. I'm not going to count them. And these are black, so it's even hard. All I'm doing is I'm taking some up in my fingernail.
And if they get lodged under your fingernail.
Then I'll have a coleus growing out of my finger. Ooh, I have some left over.
Well, fortunately, you said the surface is rough enough where those seeds aren't going to roll off.
Right.
When you move it. Move the tray, I should say.
Right. Well, I still will move it very carefully so that just in case they won't. Now, I'm going to put the water in the bottom, and I'm going to use our filtered water that we drink rather than using something out of the tap because we have softened water, and it's also city water that has a lot of calcium in it.
So we have a reverse osmosis system.
We do.
And which takes out most of the impurities.
Yes. All right, let me go get my water. All right, I'm going to start with this quart sprinkling can here and see how far that takes us.
I think you're going to need a bigger quart.
I don't know. Now I'm up to the first rung of this container, and that looks to be almost a quarter of an inch. So let me put the rest in. You probably won't be able to see my marker, but it's that little red mark there.
Mm-hmm. Now, won't these start to float if they get too high?
If
you had too much water in there, would
they? Well, probably, yes. Maybe that's why they tell you keep it at quarter to a half inch in the bottom at all times. Because these are just newly planted, I'm guessing that I'm going to have to make sure tomorrow that it has enough water in there until the sponges soak it up. Also, because this is the first time that these are being used, I'm going to lightly spray the tops of the sponges with my sprayer here.
With a mist?
Well, as fine as I can get it. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. Supposedly, I won't have to do this from this point on because I'm going to have the cover on it and the water will wick up into the sponges.
Well, be like a terrarium.
Yes.
It'll have its own ecosystem.
Yep. Okay, there goes the cover.
Well, I really like these covers compared to other growing seed kits because this is so nice and high. I mean, that right there is, I'd say, a good 6 inches in terms of height. And you could always prop it if need be, but...
Right, because in the past we've used ones that with the bottom is maybe this tall.
Right.
And then as the plants grow, obviously, and they don't need as much moisture, you eventually take the lid off, but I was ending up propping them up, trying to keep them covered, but at the same time, being high enough, it was not as nice a system as this.
Now, do you have the vents closed?
I have the vents closed. We'll see how they look tomorrow morning.
Oh, okay. So are you going to, I noticed you had some coleus here on the table.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to be putting those in those cow pots, but I have to make room. So this will be going into our green room, is what we call it, where my plant table is. It'll be in front of a southern window, but there will be plants in front of it until these sprout. So they won't be in direct sunlight. They will be in kind of a filtered sunlight.
Cool.
This will be their new home. No, we keep our house about 70 degrees, and that's pretty good. They like to sprout between 70 and 75 degrees. Plus, we have our all full-spectrum lamp above them, the window there. I'm excited to see them grow.
Well, I offered to bring the greenhouse in here.
I know. But instead, you got me a littler one. Thank you.
Okay.
Our dear friend, a gardening friend who found us on Wisconsin Garden and lives like a mile or two away, sent her husband over here last fall with these coleus for us. And all winter, they were very, very tiny when we got them. All winter, they've been sitting in a sunny window doing very nicely. And now they're begging to be put into something larger. So Veda, they are moving into a cow pot. Now cow pots are composted cow manure formed into a pot. And they come in a variety of shapes that you can use. I've never used them before, but a friend of ours, Ann, uses them all the time. When you get ready to plant your plant, whatever it is, you plant the whole pot into the ground and it'll decompose, and the nutrients of the pot will help feed your flower or your vegetable.
So it's built-in fertilizer.
It is. So I'm going to push one of these coleus out. You can see it's healthy, but it's not totally root-bound, which is wonderful. And I'm going to put it in the pot. Excuse me. And I'm going to try to keep it so that it's at the same level. So that means I have to fill up the bottom part of this with this seed starting mix.
Why wouldn't you plant it deeper?
Like a tomato, I suppose you could, because it is a coleus.
It would make the stem stronger, I would think.
This is true. Thank you. So I'll just put it all the way down to the bottom. And maybe it'll straighten itself out too, because we'll put it in a spot now where it can get sun from a multiple. I have been turning it, but they have that phototropic tendency to just move toward the sun. Okay, I pre-moistened this potting soil, because if you don't, it tends to have dry spots that if they get on the roots, your roots won't be happy.
So would I be out of line if I said you're playing in cow poop?
On cow poop, not in cow poop.
Oh. Okay.
Now I will be checking this after I water it and it settles, and I may have to put a little more soil in there.
Yeah, cows are really smart when you consider they already figured out how to recycle themselves.
Obviously, I'm not going to just put this on my table or my bench or wherever I'm putting it, because the water's going to leak right out this hole in the bottom. I have a taco salad container, the cover from that, and I will put that on there, and thus I will be recycling.
Now, if you wanted to, could you put some pellets, some stones on there, just so that the bottom isn't sitting directly in water?
When I water perfectly. There will be no water sitting in the bottom.
Oh, okay. So, three more to go, huh?
Like I said, as the soil settles in there, I'll add more. And once I know that they have recovered from being transplanted, I can start pinching off the first leaf or two to keep them from getting too leggy.
Now, if you do pinch them off, could you root those?
If I pinched off far enough, yes. Mm-hmm. And thus, I will have even more.
Ah.
water.
And that will stabilize them in this tray also.
Now, I'm sure somebody's going to ask, do these cow pots smell?
No, I don't smell anything.
I don't either. No.
Now that the coleus are transplanted or put in a bigger pot, I can move these back into the direct sun where they were before. So they should be very happy. I still have a little bit of water in the bottom, and that's okay because that can just wick up and keep the plant moist. Now, if you don't have a biodome and it's too cold to start something outside, you can use anything as a planting bed. We have found that our grocery store had their fried chicken in a container like this. Looks like a biodome, doesn't
good.
It? It even has little vents on the top so that you could close them if you needed to, or you could open them. So I have used these several times and then put in, sometimes I just used toilet paper rolls cut or paper towel rolls cut filled with seed starter. Work perfectly fine. Work very fine.
Well, you can also prop it open too.
Yes.
Once the seedlings get larger.
Right, or if it gets too wet in there, you can open it up a little bit or open all the little vents up. Mm-hmm. But it was, you know, it was very useful at the time. Keep in mind, when you go to the store, if you have nice containers that can be used for planting, go ahead and plant them. Just be sure they're clean. Now, we're going to be teaching a class to preschool teachers, and they wanted to know how to garden with children of a young age. And we decided that the kids should become seed detectives and look for different kinds of seeds. But we also wanted the kids to see how things grow. And one of the fastest growing things is grass. It's a grass seed. And so I did a little experiment, again, with a little dog food container, sprinkled some regular old grass seed on there, and it took 6 days to start growing. So that is a fast way the kids will be able to see how something goes from a tiny seed they planted to a living, growing thing that they're used to.
No, you didn't have to scratch the seeds or scarification or stratification through a cold period?
Not at all. Not for grass seeds.
Okay.
And I did water them just by spraying.
And that's just potting soil?
That's just a little bit of potting soil and regular water.
Okay.
And the reason I spray them, and the kids would love spraying them, is because grass seed is very light and tries to fly away. So spraying is perfect. Another thing we wanted to do was make sure kids knew that some of the best food they eat, is grown from seeds. And I thought we will show them how to sprout seeds. Now, this is a sprouting kit. You can make one out of a mason jar and a piece of gauze over the top. And all you do is you take sprouting seeds. These happen to be broccoli. And they're all nice and clean when you buy them, if you buy them as sprouting seeds. And you just dump them into your container or into your glass, and then you rinse them with water. Sorry. This is my diffuser so they don't jump all around like that. All right, and you get them all wet. You can look at them, and you let them drain down. Then that little tray gets emptied.
So you're just wetting, pre-wetting the
seeds. You're wetting them, right. And then you just put the cover back on, you put it on your kitchen sink. You rinse them twice a day.
What do you mean rinse them? Just like you did right now?
Right.
Just pour water over
them? Pour water over them twice a day. In 3 to 5 days, they will start sprouting. And you can eat them whenever you want, when they're tiny, tiny, or you can let them get much bigger, take the top off and let them get bigger. This is what microgreens are.
And so you can have them in your salad or even in your sandwiches or
whatever. The kids can just pick them out and eat them.
Well, I think it's a great idea to have an edible garden as well as, you know, things of beauty, flowers and plants and bushes, trees, you know.
Yes. But
to have an edible garden included makes it even more interesting, especially as you're encouraging seed detectives.
That's right.
You want to talk about that?
Well, kids come in contact with seeds all the time, and if they don't know what the seeds do, they won't know where their food comes from. So they eat an apple, there's a seed in an apple. If you're eating an orange and you come across a seed, they'll say, oh, a seed, and spit it out. Well, explain why there is a seed in there and what would happen if you planted that seed. What would come out of it?
How about hybrids, though?
An avocado is a wonderful seed for them to start with, because although it takes a whole long time for it to start sprouting, it's huge and they can watch it and they can eat the avocado, which is very healthy for them in the first place. So lots of seeds around. They have corn on the cob. Explain to them what all those little yellow things are that they're chomping away on. Those are the seeds.
Cool. I could go for some corn right now. You got the butter?
You wanted popcorn. Every time I mention something about corn, you want it.
Well, I'm hungry.
It's because you're wearing yellow today.
I know.
We hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give us a thumbs up. We truly appreciate it. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, there's that little button down there. It's over here a little bit more. Please hit that subscribe
Where
button.
Where is it?
It's over here.
Right down there. Well, you have your finger there. Hold it, finger steady. Right there. That's where it is.
Then you can become part of our garden family, and we'd love to have you as part of our family. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon. Bye for now.
So, can I start eating it?
No, they're not growing yet.
Well, can't you put them under a grow light?
No.
Connect with us on YouTube.